Good morning, everyone. From today onwards, for 15 days, we'll be revising direct taxes from 30 pages book. It's a very big misconception among the students that direct taxes is very difficult. It cannot be mugged up. It cannot be memorized. But that's not the case. We have worked really hard on this module, on making this 30 pages book to make you memorize all the chapters of direct taxes. We have used memory techniques, we have used images, we have used everything to make your life easy. So we'll start off today with capital gains. We'll start off today with capital gains, main chart and exemptions. Okay. So first of all, we need to understand that direct tax is easy. Direct tax is easy. It's not difficult. Will complete direct taxes in just 5 hours. Like I mentioned in the Telegram group, the first will use only 20 minutes per day for 15 days. That comes to 300 minutes. And that comes to only 5 hours of your life in which you can complete the whole subject of direct taxes. So we'll start off with capital gains. Okay. So, just an introduction of what I'll be covering and what I'll not be covering. We are not going to cover the Bear Act. We'll be going to cover the summary book, more or less, and the calendar book. I will not go into the Bear Act because that will take much time. Okay, so we'll start our discussion right now. Yes, so this is the chart of capital gains. Capital gains, the basic charging section of capital gains is section 45.1. So this section is 45.1. Okay. This section says, if there is a transfer of a capital asset, it will be taxable in the year of transfer. This is section 45.1. What is transfer is defined under section 2. What is capital asset is defined under section 2. Transfer is defined in an inclusive manner. So transfer includes all these: sale, exchange, relinquishment of assets. Sale means I have sold the capital asset, it will be a transfer. I have exchanged the capital asset for another asset, even it will be transfer for me and even for that person. Relinquishment is, say I'm relinquishing my right to purchase shares. So I'm selling the rights. Extinguishment. Extinguishment is not always optional. It may be mandatory. Say I had a capital asset of land, of a building or a tent, and a fire occurred. So again, that may not be optional. Conversion of capital asset into stock in trade. So there's a key understanding that you need to, key concept that you need to understand. When capital asset is converted into stock in trade, so there are two situations. A stock in trade may be converted into capital asset, or a capital asset may be converted into stock in trade. So we are talking about this situation. All right. For this situation, first, if the capital asset is converted into stock in trade, that is a transfer. Okay, but has the money received by the assessee? No, it will be received when the stock in trade is further sold. Okay, so our basic charging section used to say that in all the cases, if you have a transfer, if you have a capital asset, it will be taxable in the year of transfer. But if we tax the person in the year of transfer, it will bring them difficulty because they have not received the payment. What do we do? The government has introduced section 45.2, special transfer, which says if you are converting capital asset into stock in trade, it will be taxable in the year of stock in trade, when the stock in trade is sold. Okay. these sections. Similarly, extinguishment, for example, I had a car or any other capital asset. Say I have had a building and now a fire occurred and I have lost my rights. My rights are extinguished. So for that, we will say that the transfer has occurred in the year in which your rights are extinguished. But have you received the money? No. So for that, again, section 45(1) provides. Insurance compensation. In case of insurance compensation, it will be taxable in the year of receipt. So thumb rule you can understand for these special cases is you have to receive some benefit from the capital asset, then only you are required to make the payment of capital gains, of capital gains tax. Understood? Because if you have not received the benefit, the government has saying wait till you receive the benefit and then pay the amount to us. Okay, so transfer definition is covered under section 247. Capital asset is defined under section 214. 214 defines capital asset in a tricky kind of way. It says it capital assets means, and it says capital asset excludes. So maybe there may be something which is satisfied under the words under means, but since they are specifically excluded, capital gains will not arise. So capital gain asset means property of any kind. Property, to define property, property is something, anything which has value. So everything under the universe which has value is covered here. Okay, now we'll take the securities held by FI some moments later. Property of any kind, but it excludes stock in trade. It excludes gold deposit bonds. So property, is stock in trade my property of any kind? Yes. Is it stock in trade? Yes. So like I mentioned before, it is covered under the meaning and also covered under exclusion. So hence stock in trade is not a capital asset, but is building a capital asset? Yes, of course it is, but as per the definition. So for that, just recap, is it a property of any kind? Yes, it is a property of any kind. Is it a stock in trade? No. Is it a do we take depreciation on building use for business or profession? Yes. How can it be a capital asset? It is a capital asset. It is a depreciable capital asset. Okay, so capital asset may be of two types, one depreciable, one non-depreciable. Non-depreciable may be investments, land. Depreciable may be building, furniture. They are capital asset, but they are depreciable capital assets. Getting me? So for depreciable capital assets, we have another section which we'll discuss later. Later during this video. Capital asset means property of any kind, excludes stock in trade, gold deposit bonds, excludes personal assets, personal effects. So it excludes personal effects, and if you have a look at the Bear Act, personal effects exclude some items. It excludes sad APJ. Sculptures, archaeological collections, drawings, any work of art, paintings and jewelries. Sad APJ. Personal effects excluding sad APJ. Assets, capital assets excluding personal effects. That is the meaning of it is capital assets will include sad APJ. You're getting? So here, wherever there's a green color, it says it is excluded. Wherever there is a red color, it says it's excluded. wherever there is a green color, it is included in the definition of capital asset. Sad APJ, always a capital asset. Rural agricultural land in India, not a capital asset. In India, not a capital asset. Okay. So this is the basic charging section and the related sections. Okay. Now, like I mentioned, there is a group of special transfers. Special transfers tells us that if you have not received the payment or you have not received the benefit, don't pay us now, pay us later. Let's have a look at those sections. 45.1A insurance compensation, like we mentioned. Now, these special transfer sections have two motives. First of all, I'll tell you something else. Whenever your capital, the calendar book, whenever the charging section is satisfied, this is check. Can you write down here? Whenever your charging section is satisfied, that you understand that capital gains will arise, then you have the second step is to compute. For computation, section 48 is given. Section 48 provides this. It provides this table to compute the capital gains. So it says, take the full value of consideration, reduce expenses, you'll arrive at net sale consideration. Reduce cost of acquisition or index cost of acquisition. Reduce cost of improvement or index cost of improvement, you'll get the capital gains. From that, reduce exemptions. Reducing exemptions, you'll get taxable capital gains. Okay? Yeah. So, the starting point is full value of consideration, and we were discussing special transfers, these sections 45.1A, 45.2, 45.3, 45.4, 45.5, and 45.5. It has two motives. Okay, I'm not going through the bare act, but it has two motives. First, it has changed the year of transfer. What has it done? It has changed the year of transfer. The logic is the same. If the person has not received the money, has not received the benefit, don't pay us now, pay us later. Okay. For full value of consideration, it has second motive to prescribe the full value of consideration. Okay. So in case of special transfers, first is 45.1A, like we discussed, insurance compensation, year of receipt. It overrules 45.1. You tick this box. Why does it have to overrule 45.1? Because 45.1 provides that it will be taxable in the year of transfer. But this section provides that it will be taxable in the year of receipt of compensation. Hence, it has to override 45.1. So, and the full value of consideration is full fair market value of assets plus money received. In case of conversion of capital asset into stock in trade, when the stock in trade is sold, benefit is arrived, then that is the time when capital gains is to be paid. Fair market value of assets on the date of conversion is to be taken as full value of consideration. But the difference between sale value of stock in trade and fair market value on the date of conversion, PGVP. Fair market value on the date of conversion to cost will be your capital gains. Yeah. Compulsory acquisition of any asset. It is a transfer. Yes, it is a transfer. My rights are getting extinguished. It is getting extinguished in the year in which I have. The asset is compulsory acquired, but it will be taxable in the year of first compensation received. compensation received is a full value of consideration. Now, joint development agreement. So, let's say I am an individual. I have a house, for example, and many other people are also living in this building. Okay, and one developer comes to me and other people saying that we'll redevelop this building. It is a 4 floors. We'll make it 10 floors, and we'll give you another house, a flat in the new building. So suppose I have one house, one flat, it'll give me 2 flats. So yes, now when I'm allowing the possession of the property to that developer, I'm transferring the asset. Transfer definition includes allowing possession of immovable property. So I'm allowing him the possession of the property, but have I received the new asset? Have I received the cash? I may have received the cash, but I have not received the asset. So the government has said the asset will be received in the year in which completion certificate is received. Only then you are required to pay the tax. Logic is clear? Yeah. So joint development agreement, it says completion certificate. When the completion certificate is received, then you are required to pay tax. Amount recorded in the books of accounts will be the full value of consideration. No, so actually there's a mistake in this chart. This will go up and this will go down. Amount recorded in the books of fair market value on the date of distribution. Okay, capital contribution by partner, year of taxability is capital contributions. It is simple. 45(3) and 45(4). 45(3) partner contributes. 45(4) asset is distributed by the partnership firm. Okay. 45(3) to remember the section numbers. First the partner will contribute. Hence it is 45(3). Later the partnership firm will distribute. Hence it is 45(4). All right. So for the full value of consideration, fair market value and the rate of distribution will be considered. 45(4) is distribution by partners to the firm. Year of distribution is the year of taxability. Stamp duty value on the date of distribution plus monetary value will be considered as full value of consideration. Now we have gone through the process of check. Now we'll say that capital gains will arise. Yes, we are happy that capital gains will arise. Now we'll compute the capital gains. Okay, full value consideration, we have understood the special situations except two. Full value consideration normally is the amount that I've received, but in these specific 6 cases it may be different, right? Plus in 2 additional cases the full value consideration is different for 50C and 50CA. 50CA, section 50CA is when you are transferring the property any immovable property for a value less than stamp duty value. Is my statement correct? It is partly correct. It has been amended to include 5% benefit to the assessee, saying that if the variation is 5%, we'll accept the sales value. To state it more clearly, it says if stamp duty value exceeds 105% of sales value, say 100 sales value is 100, stamp duty value is 120, final value, if the valuation officer, there's a provision in this which provides that we can refer to valuation officer if the assessee says that my value is not the stamp duty value but less. So we can refer to the valuation officer. Valuation officer may say 110 lakhs, the final value will be 110 lakhs. Okay. 100 in the next situation, 100, 120, 130, 120 will be taken. 100, 120, 90, 100 will be taken. 100, 102, 100 will be taken. Why 100 is taken? Because it was within the band of 5%. 5% of sales value is 105 lakhs. Stamp duty value is not exceeding 105 lakhs. Hence, sales value will be taken. I had some queries regarding whether 5% band is applicable only to only to stamp duty value or even for valuation officer. This may come in a MCQ. Okay. So suppose in this case, say here, valuation officer's value was 102 lakhs. Will the final value be 102 lakhs or 100 lakhs? It will be 102 lakhs. Valuation officer does not have to take the 5% band. The valuation officer value will be final. Okay. Similar provision is for stock in trade 43CA. Okay. There are some conditions regarding reference to valuation officer. Value should not be disputed in any other appeal, court or etc. So that even if you're referring to valuation officer, don't refer it anywhere. Again, the second point is date of agreement fixing the consideration and the registration are not same. So date of fixing the consideration can be taken if any amount has been received by the any amount has been paid by any mode other than cash has been changed now. Now it has been provided, specific provisions has been provided, account paid check, account paid draft and ECS. Only these methods are allowed. Now 50CA provides that in case of unquoted shares of a company, it does not say securities, it says shares. If the consideration is less than fair market value, then fair market value will be taken as full value of consideration. Full value of consideration is over. Now we'll come to cost of acquisition. Cost of acquisition is to be deducted to compute capital gains. Index cost of acquisition may be considered in case your asset is a long-term asset. Long-term asset is an asset if the period of holding is exceeding 12 months, 24 months and 36 months. There are specific assets. Like for listed securities other than units, units of UTI, units of equity oriented mutual fund, the periodicity is 12 months. For unlisted securities. Is it securities or unlisted shares? It's shares. If you are able to write it down, please write it down that it is shares, not securities. Unlisted shares, movable property being land or building, or both 24 months, others 36 months. Okay. So we'll also after completing the whether it is a long term or short term, there are two benefits for being a long term asset. First, you'll get indexation. And second, you'll get the benefit of lower rate of taxes. So in case of equity share, units of equity oriented fund, business trust on which STT is chargeable, 15% if long term, if short term. Long term, of course, less than that. Before, previously it was exempted, now only 10%, and that too if the gains exceed 1 lakh. The excess portion will be taxable at 10%. This is securities other than units, ZCB, normal rates if short term, if long term, lower of 20% with indexation. So there are two benefits, indexation and lower rate. So if you're giving this proviso to section 112 for these specific assets, says that if you're taking one benefit, you don't have to take the other benefit. If you're taking the other benefit, you cannot take the first benefit. If you're taking indexation, higher rate. If you're taking, if you're not taking indexation, lower it. 20% with indexation, 10% without indexation. Other assets, taxable at 20%. This image should be printed on your mind. This whole image will take some effort. Let's say, say with me, long term listed securities other than units, 12 months. Units of UTI, 12 months. Units of equity oriented mutual fund, ZCB, 12 months. Unlisted shares, immovable property, land building, both, 24 months. Others, 36 months. Now we come to rates of taxes. Units of listed equity shares, units of equity oriented mutual fund, business trust on which STT is chargeable. STT, if it is not chargeable, it will come here or here or here. Here it will not come. Listed securities, say equity shares, here it will come. Normal rate may be taxable if short term. If long term, this rates may apply. Where will business trust come? Business trust, does it come here? No. Here it throws out listed securities, includes everything, units, shares, debentures, everything. But it throws out units. Now brings two units back. Units of UTI, equity unit fund. So it will be long term only if it is held for more than 36 months. Okay. And if STT is chargeable, long term 10% will be taxable. Will be the amount of capital gains tax. Okay. So you have to remember this chart, which is not difficult. Of course, in the future videos also will again come back to this chart to explain you more logic, and then we'll make it more perfect. Okay. But if you remember this chart and apply any of these provisions to any of the question in exam, you'll be successful. This is what I can say. Cost of acquisition. This is simple cases like cost of acquisition case of shares paid is amount paid. Bonus shares is nil. Sale of rights is cost of acquisition is nil. Person using purchase rights is amount paid for right, amount paid for shares. Indexation will be available if long term, but it is not allowed on bonds and debentures. It is allowed on capital index bond and sovereign gold bonds. Before 1/4/2001, cost of acquisition fair market value on the date of 1/4/2001 may be taken. So of course the assessor will take whichever is more beneficial. So whichever is higher, cost of acquisition or fair market value on 1/4/2001, whichever is higher. Cost of improvement is to be ignored. Manjula Jesha will be discussing tomorrow. So this is the basic charging section and to check whether capital gains will arise or not. Okay. Now this is another method. Now for depreciable capital assets, the act says I don't have to refer any of your provisions. I don't need any of your provisions. I don't need the checking. I don't need the computing. I'll check and I'll only compute. So the act says, in case of depreciable capital assets, full value of consideration less expenses less. This is not followed at all. You're getting the difference. Two exceptions to the whole thing. Opening WDV will be reduced. Cost of assets acquired will be reduced. Short-term capital gains will arise. Short-term capital gains will arise. Short-term capital gains will arise. Always short-term capital gains will arise. Section 50 provides that, say there are 10 rows here. If I've sold all the 10 rows, the block ceases to exist, capital gains will arise. Sales value minus WDV. Okay. If I have, say there are 10 rows, the WDV is 10,000 and I've sold only one row for 12,000. Okay. So the sales value exceeds the WDV, even if the block doesn't cease to exist, capital gain will arise. This is the format of computing capital gains in case of depreciable capital assets. Okay. Slump sale.
It also provides another challenge section. It says if you are transferring an undertaking for lump sum consideration, it will be taxable in the year of transfer. Slump sale, it is computing slump sale capital gains on slump sale as slump sale less net worth. Net worth calculation is given as assets, WDV in case of depreciable capital assets, book value of assets. In case of non-depreciable capital assets, will it take the book value of assets, but if it is revalued, will reduce the revaluation. Upwards or downward will ignore the revaluation. Less liabilities as per books will arrive at short-term capital gain or long-term capital gains. Now, this is a critical question. There are two benefits, indexation and low rate of taxes for a long-term capital asset. So which benefit is available for section 50 for depreciable capital asset? Indexation is also not available. Low rate of tax is also not available. For 50B, slump sale, benefit of lower rate of tax is available. So what is the capital asset here in case of slump sale? Undertaking. So if undertaking is held for more than 36 months, it will be a long-term capital gain. Understood? So this was all about capital gains first chart. So we'll just give 1 minute recap. Transfer of a capital, this is basic charging section. Transfer of a capital asset taxable in the year of transfer. Transfer ka definition is given above, which says it includes sale, exchange, relinquishment of assets, extinguishment of assets, allowing possession, etc., etc. Capital assets definition is given below. It says it means property of any kind, securities held by FII, excludes stock in trade, excludes gold deposit bonds, personal effects, excluding SAD APJ, means SAD APJ is a capital asset, it excludes rural agricultural land in India. So this is all about capital and capital asset and transfer. It says it will be taxable in the year of transfer. Year of transfer has certain exceptions, 6, out of which 4 overrules capital overrules 45(1)A for insurance compensation, 45(2) for conversion, 45(5) in case of compulsory acquisition, 45(5A in case of joint development. It says it will be taxable in the year in which some benefit is received to the assessee. It also prescribes full value of consideration. Once the charging section is satisfied, we go to computation. Full value of consideration less expenses, less cost of acquisition or indexed cost of acquisition in case it is long-term capital asset. Long-term capital asset, 12, 24, 36 months. 12 for listed securities other than units, units of UTI, units of equity-oriented mutual fund, ZCP. 24 months for unlisted shares, immovable property being land, building or both, 36 months for others. And then the rates of taxes for equity shares. If I can remember, so can you. Equity shares, equity-oriented fund, units of business trust on which STT is chargeable. 10% in excess of 1 lakh in case of long term. 20%, 15% in case of short term. Listed securities other than units and ZCB, normal rates, proviso 2112, which says 10% with one benefit, 20% with one benefit. Other assets, normal rates and 20%. Maximum rate of taxes in case of long-term capital gains is 20%. So these two sections, 50 and 50B, provides their own charging section, own computation. Now let's come to the first page. We'll have a just brief discussion on this. This is the basic charging section of what? Income tax. You may not know the basic charging section of income tax. It is section 4. Section 4 provides that income tax is annual tax rate is prescribed in the Finance Act. Let's go through the prescribed rates. 5%, 2,50,000 basic exemption. And for individuals, we get rebate as well. If your total income does not exceed 3,50,000, rebate of 2,500 will be available. Surcharge is 10% and 15% for all these assessees. Individual, HUF, AOP, BOI. AOP, BOI has special rate of taxes also, which we'll be discussing later.
basic exemption is 3 lakh and 5 lakh in case of senior citizen and super senior citizens. These are the rates of taxes for company and firm. 30%, 30%, 115BA provides 25%. Turnover, if it is less than or equal to 250 crores for a company, it is 25%. These are specific for companies. Local authority says 30%. Now, health and education says of 4% is applicable and not 3% says. Okay. There are two special rates of taxes as well. Carbon credits received as incentive. If suppose you get a simple question on MCQ, the rate of tax is 10%. A resident patentee, 10%. Now, if in the question or in MCQ, it is given non-resident patentee, benefit of 10% is not applicable. Normal rates of taxes are applicable. Okay.